that's and
that's go right into that too.
Joining me now is Elizabeth Dirk. Elizabeth, thank you for joining us. Tissue engineering and regenerative medicine, is medicine being redefined?
Tissue engineering is a new era in medicine. It brings together people from lots of different sciences and engineering and medicine to approach problems in medicine in a new way. And right now, a lot of times, foreign materials are used to replace what's missing. We want to shift that towards regeneration of living natural tissue. And so we want to be able to grow tissue that's going to integrate in with the surrounding tissue and grow and repair with the patient over time. And how that works is we take cells from the patient and we put them in a three-dimensional scaffold that defines the shape and size of the tissue we want to regenerate, and sometimes add biomolecules that are normally found during wound healing, and combined, they can help regeneration of, like I said, functional living tissue.
Sounds so futuristic, you know. Are we looking at a way to grow new bone? Is that what you're talking about, basically?
Exactly. So the body has the ability to repair. If you fall down and break your arm, it's going to heal. If we put these three-dimensional scaffolds in that give the cells of the body something to grow in on and some of the factors normally found during wound healing, then you can basically trick the body into growing little bits of bone until it spanned a very large distance.
So the three-dimensional scaffolding, when I think of scaffolding, I'm thinking of stuff that's supporting construction or remodeling of a building. Is it similar to that, but in the body?
It's the same idea.
Oh, wow.
What we're looking for is temporary scaffolding to kind of take up the area of a defect. And as the tissue grows in, that scaffolding isn't needed for support anymore. And ideally, it would degrade away, so you're left with natural functioning tissue.
I love the idea of using the body to actually repair itself. What about a replacement for a defective heart valve?
Not as much is known about the cells of the heart valve. Heart valve disease, which is the stiffening of the heart valve, so it's just lots of extra tissue is made. They don't know how that starts and how it progresses. And so some of the research we work on relates to tissue engineering, because if we can understand how the body creates all this extra tissue during disease, maybe we can harvest that information and use it to make just enough functional tissue.
How does material design fit into your work?
In recent years, it's been shown that the scaffold actually plays an important part in directing cell function. The cell actually reaches out and pulls on materials around it. And if it can pull easily, because it's squishy, then it's going to express some genes. If it's really stiff and can't pull very well, then it's going to express other genes. So we look at developing new materials with different material properties, like different stiffnesses, to help direct the cell function.
There's a lot of aspects to the research you're doing.
The tissue engineering is very multidisciplinary. And it's even defined as bringing engineering problem solving and life sciences problem solving to medical issues. To really do tissue engineering, you need to bring together a group of engineers, of chemists, of biologists, of medical doctors, all need to be involved in all stages of the research so you get to a product that's going to be useful to the medical community. My background is in chemical engineering and then biomedical engineering. I currently have students with backgrounds in chemical engineering, mechanical engineering, chemistry, biology, biochemistry, and they all work together on different aspects of tissue engineering projects.
What do you think makes your research at UNM so unique in this area?
We're really interested in using the materials instead of the biofactors to direct cell function. That kind of makes us on the cutting edge. Another area that makes us very unique is a lot of people use kind of the off-the-shelf materials. And there are a number of materials already proven to work well in biological systems, but they don't actually fit the bill for the given application. And what we do is we go back to the drawing board and say, okay, exactly what properties do we want this to have? What chemical properties, what physical properties? And then we design our materials basically molecule by molecule to get our desired property for a given application.
So why stem cells? Where do the stem cells come from?
The players that make the tissue are the cells. And so the choice of cell is very important in developing a tissue engineered project. And stem cells are great cells. Everybody has them. They're prevalent during development, but adults have them as well. And they're basically cells that haven't committed to what they want to be when they grow up. Mm. They haven't committed to what they're going to do. And so if you have a source of stem cells, then you can make them and direct them to become any type of tissue that you want.
Wow.
So if I can get a population of stem cells, I can, you know, direct them to become bone and help form bone, or I can direct them to become part of the heart or part of the heart valve and make heart valve tissue for us. And so they're very multifunctional.
So how close are we then to having a bone or a heart product for use in human clinical trials at this point?
The bone is definitely closer to clinical trials. On the heart valve, like I said, there's still a fair amount of basic science that needs to be done.
How close?
I hope to see products that I've seen developed used in my lifetime. Tissue engineering products are new. Scientists and lawmakers and the FDA have to work together to figure out how to approve them, how to make sure that they are safe for human use.
What's your inspiration for this?
So there's a few key points in my life that brought me to this point. When I was in high school, I was really good at biology, but I loved physics, and I had a teacher who said, you should be an engineer. Mm. And I believed him.
Good for that teacher.
And when I went to college, I said, okay, I want to do engineering and biological systems. Then I had a friend who was actually on his way to the Olympics, on the Olympic cycling team. And he got a really bad tear in the cartilage in his knee.
Oh, man.
He went to the doctor. They took all the cartilage in his knee out. They said, by the time you're 40, you won't be able to walk very well. So that's it. You know, your Olympic career is over. And at the same time, tissue engineering was just starting to make it into the news. And I turned to my friend and said, one day I'm going to make materials that are going to help you.
So is tissue engineering and regenerative medicine the next big step for medicine?
You know, they're big problems that we're looking at. And medical doctors are very smart. But they have a certain problem-solving technique. You know, bring in engineers, we think a very different way, and we look at problems in a different way. Bringing all these different people together with all these different abilities is going to answer problems that alone we couldn't have done.
Thank you so much. This is an interesting topic. Appreciate you being here today.
Well, thank you for having me.
Sure.